folks. I think most, if not all of us, have this giant pile of stuff between ourselves and what we want. So let's try getting over it. Oh. Here we are. This person in a pot with a hammer. And we're gonna get over stuff. So that's the game. And also sometimes the narrator will just pipe in, let us know, and in the meantime we'll just talk. Oh. And I'll try to get over this thing. It's gonna be tricky because I'm a little bit rusty since I haven't played since yesterday and all. Gotta be careful with this game. It's very easy to lose all of your progress. Alright, so. I think last time I wanted to be under here. Like this. And I want to slowly make my way back down. Careful. Okay. So just gonna carefully, move ourselves under this little pile thing. I haven't been this far yet, but, the game is making me go, back up and across and over places I've been. To make it so that if you fall, well, you're back where you started, kinda. So this is... Stakes are high. Stakes are pretty high in here. Also, I can't see the chat because of this stuff I have here, so... There we go. Okay. So yeah. Also, hey, if you'd like to talk about the things that are in your way, feel free. We're not here to judge... or to scream or to rail against the things that we need to do. We're here to help each other out in getting over it. Pepper, I'm not the boss of whether or not you get a hammer. Alright, let's see how this works. I think I'm gonna have to, do this.
I feel within me a peace above all earthly dignities, a still and quiet conscience. William Shakespeare.
Now, this is tricky, so we're back here. That's okay. I'm gonna bring myself here and then do this. Whoop, and back we go. And back we go. It's easy to mess up this specific little move. But it's okay, we just keep trying. Nope. Whoa. Bring yourself back here. And we try again. Oh, here we have to be very careful. Because if we fall here, we fall very far down. So we just gotta be careful. Some of the controls are tricky also, not always super intuitive. Whoops. Yeah, that part's real tricky. Oh, I'm a little quiet. I'm sorry. I should move closer to the mic. I'm lounging away from the microphone. This is not good television. Yes, we are playing Getting Over It by Bennett Foddy, maker of Quap and GURP and some other really interesting games. I really like GURP. You know, I should probably switch to GURP once I feel I'm done with this, because GURP is a very nifty game by Mr. Foddy. Position myself here. I'm having trouble with this part tonight. And we slowly make our way back here. Hey, Jeb. Yes, the gang's all here. Oh, I forgot to adjust my little friends. Here you go. Yeah, this game is a pretty good Sisyphus simulator. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Pepper. Hopefully things turn up. Boop. Yeah, this game just came out. It's very heavily inspired. Whoa. By a game called Sexy Hiking. Okay, how do I get up?
You cannot now believe that you will ever feel better. But this is not true. You're sure to be happy again. And knowing this, truly believing it, will make you less miserable now. Abraham Lincoln.
Abraham Lincoln said that? What? Really? Huh. That's interesting. I would have really liked pegged that as a line from like a self-help book. Sometimes stuff make us sad, and that sucks, and there's a lot we can do, but just hold on and wait until we feel a little bit better. Because usually we will eventually feel better, because every day we're a little bit stronger. But it takes time, and it sucks. It still sucks even though we know that it's gonna get better, because that doesn't actually make it suck any less now. This is a little bit precarious situation I've gotten myself in here. Yeah. There. All right. Whoa. Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, I don't think I've seen many games where your character is not actually the interaction character. Oof. Also interesting, the fact that this game has licensed music means that I cannot monetize the YouTube versions of these videos because the owners of the musical
copyrights
basically monetize the video for me. So makes it a little bit tricky to stream this game, but that's okay. Oh my gosh, thank you
that's
so much
great.
For the song, Jeb. Your subscriptions really helped
you
me out.
You did it! It's great job!
This one might be. There was another one yesterday. Well, I think yesterday? The last time I played this game that was not public domain. And YouTube basically told me, okay, the owner of the song is monetizing your video. Sorry about that. Gosh, you really can't play this game when you're impatient. Because this game is, like, very tricky. And also will, like, yeah, it's about, like, losing constantly. It's about constant failure.
You did it! Great job!
Oh my gosh, thank you so much, Pepper! Whoa! Thank you! Cannot see the cursor. Okay. No, not really what I want to do. Thank you. This sound like my Patreon. Books I make, the things I sell, the subscriptions here, they all help me out a heck of a lot. They let me keep doing this. And that's really important to me. I guess I could, I try to play this game for an hour. I might make it, I might not. It really depends on just how much, like at some point, I might just get a little bit like, I might lose my nerve and just like become unable to play adequately. And at which point I might just stop.
Do not
see, this
stand
part is so hard.
Cry. I am not there. I did not die. Mary Fry.
Oops. Probably will not try to go across it from the bottom of this pile of cardboard boxes. That would probably be a bad idea.
Whoops. To live is to suffer. To survive is to find some meaning in the suffering.
I'm thinking Bennett planned that this place would be very difficult. Wee! You can really get some momentum in this game. I'm really curious to see what the speed run of this game will be like. I would very much like to see that. I hope someone speeds run this game. Okay, I'm not getting very far here. Nah. Just needed a little bit more. Oh yeah, like the myth of Sisyphus is a heck of a thing. I should maybe read this book, but I don't know if I actually have it in me to read this whole thing. Oh, I'm so glad, Pepper. This is such good news for you.
That's great.
Hey, thanks for the follow. I don't usually play frustrating games. Just that today, like, there's this game. And it's been kind of a rough, like, few weeks. So I figure, like, this is appropriate. Also, it just came out, so whoop. Well. Not even looking in the right direction. He's like showboating, like, I don't even need to look at the hammer. Whoops. Okay, that's actually. Whoa. Oh, okay, there we go. Hi, little child. Pay no attention to the weird things that's happening right now. Hope things get better soon. No. Okay. We gotta be careful. Yeah, I have no clue when this game ends, but that's fair. That's okay. Pay no attention to the shirtless man in a cauldron. Everything cool. Yep. Go, all is well.
Life is a mosaic of pleasure and pain. Grief is an interval between two moments of joy. Peace is the interlude between two wars. You have no rose without a thorn. The diligent picker will avoid the pricks and gather the flower. Satya Sai Baba.
wonder what happens if you go left at the very start of the game. That's a good question. I don't know if you can. Something to try at some point on future playthroughs. I wonder if this is going to do the same thing that happens with GURP. So yeah, I definitely want to like play some GURP. Possibly tonight. Here we go. Yeah, the stairs are like, phew. I'm not sure. Yeah, we don't know why this person is in a pod.
Sorrow is my own yard, where the new grass flames as it has flamed often before, but not with the cold fire that closes round me this year. William Carlos Williams.
Sometimes it does this weird thing where it kind of like launches me this way. And I feel that's when, like, you can lose control more easily. Like, this, you really did not plan for physics to do this. Like, here, I almost, like, dropped and lost all of my progress. That would have been bad. So there's a very real possibility that I will not make any progress tonight. Well, that's not true. I've already made a little bit of progress. But this game is still super hard.
When games were new, they wanted a lot from you. Daunting you, taunting you, resetting and delaying you. Players played stoically. Now everyone's turned off by that. They want to burn through it quickly. A quick fix for the fickle, some tricks for the clicks of the feckless. But that's not you, you're an acrobat.
Hmm.
You could swallow a baseball bat.
I could not swallow a baseball bat. Yeah, okay, the next jump is something real harsh. I guess this is where the game kind of like shows its colors. We're like, oh no, this is like, it's very like Bennett Foddy-esque to like only give you one shot at something and then you fall all the way down if you can't master it on the first shot. I think that's a bit unfair, but again, like this is kind of what this game is. It's a game about unfairness. Also these weird mechanics that I'm not a big fan of, but yeah, there's like this is kind of what you're signing up for when you're playing this game. Come on, there we go. Physics of this game is so weird. Okay. Let's pause pause for a moment. There we go. All right. Wonderful. All right. Another one of the things that were unresolved has been resolved. So hey, during this stream, things got better. How does this game fit into the recent Discord about game accessibility? Basically, like, this is a mouse game. You need to be able to do very precise and sometimes quick movements with the mouse. If you can't, you can't play this game. However, the game can also be played via trackball. I'm assuming that helps with the accessibility, because there's some things you can do with a trackball that you can't with a mouse, and there's ways to control a mouse that, like, you can do via other peripherals. But, like...
That's great!
See, thanks for the follow! Like, I'm assuming there are people who can't play this game because of the precision and the type of, like, movements required. That might be, like, the case. And, yeah, like, there's some types of game that you can't make accessible to everyone, but you can make it accessible to a lot. Which is why I think I really like the trackball inclusion, because I think that, like, helps broaden the scope a little bit. All right, so, I kind of need to hook myself on this camera over there, so... I wonder if I can, like, do some form of, like, swinging from here? Kinda. Yeah, this is gonna be, like, real tricky. I can't really hook myself on anything else. That camera... Oh, wait, okay, hold on. Maybe I can, like, draw myself here. Will I actually stick here? Not really. Okay, hold on. Okay, I can kind of do this. I just need to get the angle right. But I think that might be what we're trying to do here. Okay, not
You'll
that.
You'll be back here again and again. Avenge and repent until you've ascended. Or until you're contented.
Because, see, I need to push with some force here, some speed. So, oh, gosh, almost. So, yeah, that, like that. I think that's what I'm supposed to do. But it's a physics-y game, so if you can make it work...
That's great!
Whoops. Oh, there we go. Yeah, sometimes it kind of loses the plot, and that makes it difficult. Ugh. Thank you for the follow. Nope. All right. Yeah, this is tricky. It might actually not be what I need to do here. It's like swinging from side to side is actually way more powerful than the push. But the push worked. But yeah, it's like pushing and then maneuvering it. See, there's like this little bit of lag that happens. Nope. Like these movements, you kind of eventually get in the groove.
balloon, or will be soon. Take my baby, don't hurry home. Oh, whoopsie-doo, life won't fly new. My baby's gone away. Running around in a spin, I don't know where to begin. Oh, whoopsie-doo, life won't fly new. My baby just...
And see, I did like a push, and that was like a super powerful push. But I can't really reproduce it, and see how close I came to just losing everything there. Gosh, yeah, there's stuff you can do in this game, but it's tricky. Yeah, there's lots of resources, and Unity is starting to get resources to like give you a filter to see with different types of colorblindness to check for that kind of stuff. But it's like there's a ton of tools. It's like the least you can do is have a like colorblind option for the game for the sensitive parts, and also like be conscious of what is sensitive. You know, I think I'm gonna stop here because I'm just not making it through here, and I'm starting to lose my coordination. My palm's getting sweaty. It's like, nope, this isn't really working. And I really want to show you GURP. So I'm gonna see if I can get back to a good spot and then probably just stop there. Ooh. Alright, let's stop here for tonight. And then we're gonna play GURP. Then quit. Alright. Okay, let's see. Can I actually... How do I even play GURP? Can I download GURP? Oh, it's available for iPhone now. What? Huh? Okay. Okay, this is gonna be tricky. Okay, well, let's try this. Okay. Gonna have to add a window capture. Yep, this one. All right. Let's see. Also, hey, I guess who like shops at Dress Lily a whole lot? That's me. All right. I absolutely did not want to move this. Okay. Gosh, dang it. Okay. I think this is actually where it's supposed to be. Oof. Okay. I think this is it. All right. Nope. Let's try this, I guess. Oh, but yeah, I agree. Like, you should be doing the most you can to make the game accessible. There are some types of games that just some people will never be able to play, and that sucks. But everything you can do to make it accessible, you probably should, especially early on since it's so cheap to do. Okay, we're good. All right, so let's see if this works. Now press R to resume. There we go. Okay, so controller shift, flex muscles, everything else to move your hands. So this is good. So you're this person. Oh yeah, absolutely. Like if you have remap controls, that's the way to do remap controls. I think latest Rayman games did that pretty well. Okay, so hey, here's a bunch of letters. Cool, there we go. So okay, I can shift. There we go. There we go. Okay, I have F. What else? I can do D. Alright, D. Alright, cool. Now, U. There we go. And then A. A. Alright, A. Alright, can I get the J? Almost. There we go, got the J. Didn't get the Q. And basically. Oh, the game is too loud. Well, that's a problem. Because I can't actually. Can I what happens if I click outside the window? I think I'm boned. Alright, cool. I'm gonna try. Is this better? Oh, it just pauses it? Okay, cool. Desktop audio, there we go. See, this is nice. It actually has you press the right key. Alright, cool. Also, hey, we got a friend now. Now we have a friend. Barely can. All right, let's try E then. And then B. All right, we have B. Oh, the kick the bird. So we have a bird friend now. Oh, come on. You can do it. Grab the O. All right, cool. Get away, bird. So the bird is actually obscuring letters and making it like impossible to grab certain rings. Okay, F T. Oh, let's try the Z. Go away. Jerk bird. No, not literally any other letter. Gosh, dang it. Bird. There we go. Okay. And. Didn't change. I specifically lowered. Can you hear me better? Is that working? Okay, cool. Alright, that's not working. How about Q? Nope, because the bird's gonna. Okay, maybe. Well, let's try a little over under. Oh, almost. It's too bird. Gosh, dang it, bird. Oh, almost had it. My controls are basically like keys and then flexing my arms or not. All right, so this is not working. Let's try something else. All right, well, let's see if I can go back here. Yeah, this way. Flip around. You can probably get Y. Come on, buddy. There we go. Well, maybe I can grab N. Almost. Okay, well, in that case, D. Do a flip with N. J. Go for the I. Go for the I! And then M. Oh, absolutely. Hey, gosh, like, I was... I did the best I could fighting for accessibility in Chariot, and even then it was hard, because especially with, like, with when you're working for a large studio that it might not be, like, very accessibility-minded, they just might not care. And if you have a small studio, it might just be too expensive to do some stuff. But again, if you implement some stuff early on, it's very cheap. And also in a recent talk that I did, it kind of worked out that hey, a lot of accessibility features are also features that help speedrunners. So you can like actually make your game more accessible for two types of audiences at the same time, and that might be enough for the more pragmatically minded people. Like, oh, I absolutely need a money reason to do this thing. Well, here you go. You have, like, multiple markets who will now be able to play the game, and that's important. And accessibility features and speedrun features tend to also, like, get more attention, because there's still so few of them, so, like, it's, like, an unfortunate part of making games that I've learned a lot of, like, how to say things in a way that the marketing people will, and like the people who like decide where the budget goes will actually like say, okay, you can do the thing. And that really sucks. Yeah. A lot of this game is like figuring out how to like do the, okay, swing. I played this game a lot when I was, like, working on Chariot. Because, again, like, Chariot has a lot of this figuring out the momentum. Alright, this isn't gonna work. Go away, you bird! Go away, bird! grab it, it's right there. There we go. Right. That bird will just never give up. Go away! Holy crap. Yeah, the bird never goes away. That's just not something the bird does. The bird is not programmed to go away. Also, imagine the gymnastics, and this is the beauty of this game, the gymnastics your hands have to do on the keyboard to play this game. It's like you are actually straining, pressing multiple keys. It's, in a way, it's kind of making you feel like the character who is climbing across this precarious rock and being beset by this nefarious bird. Oh, you almost had it there, buddy. There we go. This game is not endless. This is a curated experience. Also, keep in mind, you can also do some weird stuff at some point, but I'll see if, like, I will need to actually do this. Grab the deke. Grab it, grab that ring. Oh, come on! There we go. Okay. Probably do an underhanded thing. Oh, I was so close. There we go. Also, the water is rising under me this whole time. Hey, Shy. It's not really a timer per se, but there is sort of a limit that, like, is making sure that you don't take too long. My trick is that I use two fingers plus my pinky to work the shift, and basically each finger is an arm, and I always make sure to press the corresponding, like, I'm using my right hand for the right arm, so I never get, like, confused. and let go of the wrong one. This does make it tricky, though. Alright. Oh, Night Pixel, Night Pepper. Thank you. Please take care. Alright, now do you see what's coming up here? Go. Alright. There we go. Had to like let go for a moment there. There we go, that's what I wanted. Awesome. Okay. This one might be just a little bit tricky though. Let's see if we can do it. Okay, there we go. Then we can get right hand in the right place. Also, the bird's gone. Did you notice that? Bird's gone, everybody. We're good. Now we can finally, like, do the things we wanted to do. Oh my gosh, single controller co-op for this game would be something. There we go. How are we gonna get there though? Okay, I think I can grab the M. Oh, there we go. Okay. And now the present has a letter on it. Oh my gosh, you... No, the bird got the present. So now I press space to restart. And now we start again. But, if you notice at the bottom, personal best, 18 minutes, 57 seconds. Now it's a race against time. Now it's not like, usually your personal best is the highest you went. Now it's, okay, how fast can you make it? And this is when you start to like, learn like, oh, the risky things you can do. It's like you can like launch yourself and do stuff like that. And this is what this game is. It's a thing. Can I just like play the other games? Will that just work? Yep, getting over it. That's a thing. Okay. Oh, well. There we go. Okay, cool. You probably know Quap. You're Quap, our small nation's sole representative at the Olympic Games. Ideally, you will run 100 meters, but our training program was underfunded. Remember, it's not about whether you win or lose. So yeah, this is the game that started it all.
You did it! Great job!
Thank you so much for the subscription. Oh. Showing real courage, you ran 0 meters. Everyone is a winner. Ow. So yeah, this game is a lot of this. No. It's hard to hear it, but if you kind of can get a good rhythm going. Oh my gosh, I... This game's tricky, by the way. Almost did something there. Gosh, I used to be able to like get a groove. Come on. No. if you actually keep the run going, it plays like that classic song. I forget what it's called. Da 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 da. 45 meteors, that's pretty good. Yeah, Chariots of Fire. Also, I almost made it, but... Hey, Mike. Block. No, other direction. Other direction. Other direction. Yes, this direction. Almost. Almost had a recovery there. Like, so many lunch breaks were lost to this game when it came out. But yeah, it's like, it's just such an interesting, silly game, and you really, like, get some empathy for your character. You want to succeed. Yeah, you can do the shimmy, but the thing I love also is that if you, like, it's a 100 meter race. If you make it to 50 meters, there's a hurdle. And that's just, like, the best. Of course there's a hurdle. Of course. And see, what else is there? There's, like, gosh, Bennett made a bunch of games. Yeah, that is essentially it. I like GURP. It's one of my favorite old games. You can do really tricky things with it. Eventually, you get, like, real good. Eventually, you don't, though, because it's been a while. But some of my friends used to, like, oh, do, like, spin flips and jumps and careening across the level. And that was the thing. So, that's going to be it for me. Thank you so much for dropping by. It's been fun getting over it, even though we didn't. And climbing to the top of that mountain to get that present, even though we didn't. But hey, stuff happens. We do our best. You overcome it, and even if we don't, even if it feels like we're back where we started, we still learn. We're a little bit better than when we were there the first time, so that still counts. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, thank you so much for dropping by, and for the follows, and for the subs. They keep me going, literally. I really, really appreciate it. So, till we see each other again. Please take care of yourselves because you are important. Let's keep making wonderful things together.